I say this rock looks like a fiendish grinning skull, and there's a spot you could insert something. I feel certain I've seen something the same shape as this indentation, but I can't bring it to my mind. Blast it. Hold on, I'm gonna do something I don't normally do. So Delta has said something on it, and Bobbery has, so let's do Vivian next. This rock looks like looks a lot like a skull. And you could fit something inside this little spot in the eye. I feel like we've seen something that's the same shape as this little indentation. Interesting rock, looks quite a bit like a skull. Oh, and there's a spot in this eye that would fit something. And the shape of the indentation, I feel certain I've seen something like it before. Cuckoo skull rock, huh? There's a spot in the eye that looks like it could hold something. Wait, the shape of this indent looks like something I've seen somewhere. This rock looks kind of like a skull. Oh, and it looks like that one spot in the eye could fit something inside. The shape of this indentation, I feel like I've seen something that could fit here. So what did she say? Let's go to Flavio, let's go tell Flavio that Bowery's okay. As skull-shaped rocks go, this is an excellent one. There's even a spot here in the eye to insert something. And doesn't that shape of that indentation remind you of something? Something you've seen recently? I know it's something you're gonna do with these pillars, but I'm pretty sure you can't actually do it until you have put the thing in there. And yes, there should be something nearby. Is it hiding in the foreground? Yep, of course it is. See, I'm, like, there's certain things I'm better about, I think, now that I'm a little more experienced, and, I mean, even though I feel like I'm not the best guy to ask between what they have changed and what they haven't changed between the original and the remaster, I still feel like because I've played the original, I just have, like, a better sense of how to find things and how the game hides items and stuff, right? Actually, while we're here, I'll grab a few more coconuts, just in case I need them for any ingredients or anything. There's a chance I might need it for something from the health board, so. You know what I'm going to do? I want to make it one last goal, because I'm probably going to end this recording session once we get back to, once we get back to camp. I think getting Bobbery and getting a level up would be a good way to end this part. Alright, well that breaks the streak of getting 9, so. Also, I'm totally out of FP, so. It's not help. Ow, whoa, whoa, whoa. I'll probably just sell that. I think that's good. God damn it. I don't know why. Yeah. Alright, now we're gonna go use it at our in coop. Sleep tight. I figure we should use at least one. Figure why the heck not. Alright, let's go get a quick level up in. Probably only take one or two fight, well, two or three fights. The Quake Hammer is cheaper, right? I'm pretty sure it is, so definitely, this definitely burns through my FP a little faster. Even with the reduction one I have on. The badge I have on that takes it down by one. Crowd of booze. I see a bright blue object down there. That boo might throw something for me. Interesting. I almost don't want to, like, wrap this fight up too fast. Oh, well, there you go. I mean, that's not what I was looking at, but... Actually, now that I see it, I see, like, two bright blue... Okay, there's multiple. That might just be part of the set. I was thinking it was an item or something, but, you know. And there we go. We are gonna go to 27. Been the plan. Let me actually put the badges on before I forget. Take more damage proof when attacking jumping on fire enemies. What a good time to get this, right? Attack power against fire enemies increased by 1. Fire damage and damage taken from fire attacks drops by 1. Okay, so currently we have hammer throw on. Take that off for a minute. Put quick hammer on. And that leaves us with 2 open. I think we should be running into a lot of fire enemies inside, right? I think we'll put on ice power for now. And then probably hammer throw as well. Alright. Let's talk to Flavio. Ah! It is Bobbery. Welcome back to you. Do you know how worried we were? My stomach has been most upset. I must worry about everyone here, but who worries for Flavio? No one. Do you know how hard that is for me? To sit here in safety and worry so much? I do not know what is out there, waiting to lurch in and stalk upon me. We do not even know how to get home, but for sake of the blue, briny sea. But no more yelling. Now is the time to pull together and work as a team. Clevy, old boy, I must say, you talk rather too much. Such insolence, grr. I growl at you like an angry jungle beast I ought to. So in any case, Mario, about that crystal star you spoke of earlier. There was a rather odd rock at that far east of the jungle with a skull carved into it. Call it an old sea bomber's intuition, but that skull rock smells suspicious. Suspicious. Hey, Bobbery, you want to know what really smells suspicious? Flavio's armpit. Oi, smells like low tide. Ha 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 ha. But seriously, you may be onto something. With that skull rock, I say, that's where the treasure is. Well, anyone could figure that out, you mutinous joker. I mean, how obvious. I was already saying in my head that the treasure is certainly behind that rock. And as such, I will continue the noble duty of protecting this camp from invasion. Captain Mario, carry on. I'm sorry to make so many requests, but you know. Love you, old cash grabber. Crash grubber. If you want treasure, why don't you go get it yourself? Oh, well, yes, Admiral, you see, I... Well, yes, you have a point. Let us decide this fair and square, shall we? Listen to me, everyone. Who thinks I should go along to investigate the Skull Rock? Oh, heck yes. Take it with fun to get it off with you. There you have it, Flavio. Fair and square. Eh, what? No, not fair. Flavio hates you all. Flavio will join your party for a short time. Alright, well that is where I'm going to stop for now. Because I know that... I would kind of say that we're going to be heading into like the second part of the chapter. As it were. The second half. So... I think this is a good place to stop. And hopefully pick it up. Tonight when I record, and I mean this session's 5.5 hours long. 4 hours of that was just optional side questy stuff, so. And that will be fun to edit, because I'll definitely be making some longer episodes with that. Like, pretty much all the glitch pit stuff will be its own, will be like probably two separate videos for the most part. And then the doing the 40 floors of Pit of 100 Trials, that will also likely be its own video. Because again, I'm trying to make it where it's easy to skip certain things if you really don't care. Like if you really want to just get back to the main stuff, or if you don't care for the Pit of 100 Trials and me deciding to grind in the Glitz Pit, to just to get back to rank 1 and all. I want that stuff to be, like, easy to skip, and you're not going, like, oh, I have to I'm going through, like, 20 different videos to get back to the actual either help board or even the main quest. So, yeah, and sorry, too, I know for, like, in terms of watching a playthrough, that might make it a little uninteresting for a while to be watching, like, side quest after side quest after side quest. Definitely from here, it should be paced a little better in that regard, because I had, you know, that was 4 chapters worth of build up on the help board or whatever, so it was just inevitably it was gonna kind of be that way. So I wanted to just take care of all to get the coins and anything that would be given to me as a reward, you know, get a good head start in that sense. Yeah, I think. What are they? Yeah. Wait, it literally just takes your current your current strain, that's funny. Usually those use like some pre-chosen thing, right? So we should have a Bobbery on the screen now, shouldn't we? Yep, there he is. And Miss Mouse. I wasn't 100% sure if she would show up, but because she's an optional party member, so if you wanted to argue she's not integral, sure. So once again, thank you to Ghost Cabbit. They made this model. Thank you to SnowHusky for doing the VRM work and the model work for, well, changing the colors and whatnot, getting it to be more Snow Fox-esque. And yeah, that will do it for this recording session. And definitely next recording session will be a lot more focused on finishing up the chapter, and then I don't know, I would love to get chapter 6 done as well, maybe in that recording session, if I start early enough and everything goes well enough. Chapter 6 is usually, I've usually considered it like my second favorite chapter. I've always been a big fan of the train sequence bit of it, so. But yeah, that will be for later. And yeah, I think that's all for now. So thank you guys so much for watching, and until next time, ciao for now. Bye.